ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. They will be reclining on their couches in heaven and they will be given the drink, purified wine. It would not turn the person intoxicated. And it doesn't taste bitter, no. Its taste is very sweet and palatable. And its seal is made of musk. So let the competitors and let those who desire that compete in this regard. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ وَمِزَاجُهُ مِنْ تَسْنِيمٍ عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invited us in the Quran to compete with one another, to compete for achieving what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for the righteous ones. Not just to settle for all what I want is just to enter heaven. How do you know that you're going to make it to heaven? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regularly said to his companions, إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ عَزَّ جَلَّ الْجَنَّةِ فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسَ الْأَعْلَى. Aim high. Aim very high. Do not say, I will just enter heaven. No. I would like to be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the highest of paradise. In Al-Firdaus Al-A'la. That's why when Rabi' ibn Ka'b Al-Aslami radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda, one of the companions who used to serve the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and sometimes would spend the night in his house in order to pour water for his wudu whenever he gets up for prayer. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to reward him and said, Ya Rabi'a, salni. The word salni means ask of me, ask from me. Ask of anything that I can reward you with. What would you like? So Rabi'a ibn Ka'b al-Islami said, Amhilni ya Rasulullah. This is a very unique opportunity that a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking somebody, is giving somebody the offer to ask from him. Huh? What would you like? Obviously, if any of us, if me, I would say, Ya Rasulullah, I want to go to heaven. Because this is the highest, the ultimate goal of each and every believer. But is there anything that is more superior to going to heaven? Oh yeah, big time. Big time. Some of the Sahaba used to say, if in heaven we don't get to see the Prophet, then this is not heaven. So that's why Rabi'a ibn Ka'b al-Islami took his time to think, then he turned to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are you still, is the offer still valid? سَلْنِي يَا رَبِيعَ. I said, Ya Rasulullah, أَسْأَلُكَ مُرَافَقَتَكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. I ask you to be with you in heaven, not just to enter heaven. Very intelligent. Look at, they aim high. They're not lowly people. You know the word dunya literally means what? The lowest of the low. Dunya, low, very low. So subhanallah, we go for the low and we leave the superior. أَسْأَلُكَ مُرَافَقَتَكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Ya Rabi'a, أَوَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ. Ask anything else. He said, Ya Rasulullah, you give me an offer and I picked it up. Nothing but that. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Well, if this is the case, Ya Rabi'a, then help me out to achieve your goal. How? فَأَعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكَ بِكَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ. Help me out by making much of sujood. We spoke 2 days ago and yesterday and we said that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained upon us is only 5 daily prayers. So what do you mean أَعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكَ بِكَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ? That's pertaining النوافل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says في الحديث القدسي, ما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه. There is nothing that the servant can make in order to draw near to me better than fulfilling what I have ordained on him. The 5 daily prayers, fasting during Ramadan, doing the Hajj first time, etc. And my servant, after fulfilling the fard, will continue to draw nearer to me through offering and nawafil until I love him. So there is then a higher level, which is, there is a level which is to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is a very high superior level. But there is even a higher level, which is to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through competing with regards to doing the nawafil. حتى أحب What if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you? Then this is it for you, my friend. This is it. You are a winner. You are the luckiest person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصُرُ بِهِ وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطُشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّهُ وَلَئِنْ اسْتَعَاذَ بِي لَأُعِيذَنَّهُ. This is it. You will become a chosen servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your eyesight, your hearing, your hands, your feet, everything will be totally controlled by Allah. As shaitan will have no share in you. And Allah promises, if you ever ask from Him, He will deliver immediately. If you ever seek His protection, He will deliver immediately. As a result of what?
His love. His love to you.
Okay, because He loved you. And this love, how did you earn it? As a result of doing as much as you can of nawafil. So the door of nawafil is open wide, as long as one would not turn to the extreme. The door of nawafil in every ibadah is open wide. And this is what is the mean, and this is the meaning of وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. Let the competitors compete. In order to achieve this status, everybody should compete. في سورة الحديد, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سابقوا. So في سورة المطففين, وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. Competition is prescribed. في سورة الحديد, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, race you all together. سابقوا, it's a race. This life is all about racing. اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Seize the opportunity of five before you are being seized by five calamities. Seize the opportunity of your life before you die, of your health before you get sick, of your youth before you turn old, of your richness before you turn poor. So whenever you are in a condition which would enable you to compete, to do as much good deeds as you can, then do not waste this opportunity, because nothing lasts. Nobody lives healthy forever. Nobody remains young forever. Nobody is immortal. Everybody is a human being amongst us, is subject to sickness, to poverty, to death, to disability. So seize the opportunity of the condition which you're enjoying in order to accumulate as much good deeds as you can. سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض. سابقوا, race you all together towards what? Towards what? What is the prize that's waiting us? But there is one thing before Jannah, ya Sheikh. سابقوا إلى مغفرة. Not a single time the word race was mentioned only towards heaven, because you have to have a passport. You have to have a password to cross, to get through. في سورة آل عمران as well. وسارعوا إلى جنة. No. إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. Surah Al-Hadid, verse 21. Surah Al-Imran, verse 123. Surah Al-Hadid, سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله. Surah Al-Imran, وسارعوا, once again, and be quick, race all together, towards a forgiveness from your Lord and Jannah as wide as the heavens and the earth. This musara'ah, and this competition is a praiseworthy one. Competition with regards to dunya, collect as much as you can. Fine. But you only benefit out of that what you eat, then execrate. What you wear until you tear. And what you give in a charity, and that's your deposit, that's your saving account, and this is your investment. Besides that, you leave it behind and you go. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أيها الناس توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه فإني